Yes, I go to my next issue po. This is a very minor incident, but it's getting very viral in the internet. This happened in Dumaguete about 2 weeks ago. It's just about a dog, a service dog. You know, more and more people come here, especially foreigners. They have service dogs with them. Sometimes you ride the plane and you see a dog beside you. Kasi pala, service dog yan with an international license for PWDs. Ang nangyari dito, pinagbawalan siya pumasok sa mall kasi no pets allowed ho raw. So, ang nangyari, inaresto pa siya ng police, pinusasan pa, dinala pa sa... So, as in, ako, taga Dumaguete, city of gentle people, talagang nakakahiya. And tourism-wise, pag nag-viral to, nakakahiya ho talaga. And when I check, sumakay pa siya dun sa airline, na yung mayari ng mall, yung airline na rin yun. Sabi ko, pinasakay nyo sa airline nyo, hindi nyo pwedeng papasukin sa mall nyo kasi no pets allowed. Eh, at least man lang po, our tourism industry, our private and public institutions, our tourism police, must know international laws and follow them kasi ho, talagang nakakahiya. I have a copy po, I will give it to you later.
We'll appreciate that, so we'll look into it.
Nakita ko kasi ho, sa ano nyo, sa report kanina, you have the continuing education, right, and promotion of human rights. I hope masama to because tourism wise, as I said, this is ano, very serious, and it's very viral now in the internet. You can check it for later.
Again, brief comment from Commissioner.
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you for bringing that up.
Yeah.
The CHR has done a lot of work,
yeah,
in our tenure on persons with disabilities, whether it's developmental or physical. Unfortunately, and then it really goes very well with the CHR's work on business and human rights, because
yeah,
in that it's not just people in armed forces or in uniform who might violate human rights. Nakikita rin natin even private companies. So we've seen certain companies are doing better and other companies are not doing so well, and as you may be aware of, it is that same airline which also said when there were two passengers who had developmental challenges, they said our policy is only one passenger who has that kind of a disability.
Kasi hindi in one airplane.
Flight attendant namin. So they offloaded.
Yeah,
that was what,
yeah,
2 years ago.
Yeah.
So we can see now, thank you with the information that you give us, which companies in particular need a little bit more monitoring and advocacy.
Yes, po.
Thank you.
Once again po, thank you ma'am. Thank you, Michelle.
Oh, sir, if I may add, the Philippines has had an accessibility law, so it's not just the international law that was violated. It was also our own
laws. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you. Let's